The time we saw you was when Shamir and I and our friends came to, we were going to Chicago. On the way, we stopped in Cleveland.
Yo.
Can we talk about this real quick? Like the Cleveland experience?
Yeah. I mean, how was it?
Well, for us, it was depressing.
It was like a, I always say this, it was like an indie, perfect movie set for an indie film.
Yeah. Mm.
That's
and,
true. Yeah.
And, but the thing that really scarred me was your cat.
The cat. Oh, the cat wouldn't let her sleep. Oh. You were like spraying it.
I love cats.
I heard about this cat.
I love cats.
Shout out Otto.
Otto was...
Oh, such a cute name.
I know.
Yeah. Otto was...
Like from Rocket Power?
Yeah. Like, well, no. I don't know why we got that name. I wanted to name him something else, but my roommate and I compromised on Otto. But I like that name.
It's such
Rocket
a cat
Power,
name,
yeah.
though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think when we got there, Riley hadn't been there for a week. I don't think none of your roommates have been there for a week.
Yeah, yeah.
And so your cat hasn't seen a human being in a week.
Yeah, yeah. I would just leave him there.
And he was so excited to see human beings, and he was really attached to me.
Yeah, because he knew you. He could smell your fear.
It wasn't the fear. He knew I had work to do.
Oh, right. Shami was like editing the vlogs.
I was editing the
daily,
vlogs.
Daily, right?
Yeah, yeah. Now I remember. Yep.
And so then he was like, oh, he's awake. Everyone else is sleeping. Let me make it worse for him when he's trying to sleep.
Did he like walk on your computer?
Yeah.
What's up?
Did he walk on your computer or anything?
He walked on my computer. Oh, when I tried to sleep, he tried to sleep on my lap. Yep. Did not.
Some of the guys, we would exchange, we were trying to like toss the cat in each other's rooms. Mm-hmm. So like at one point, I think towards the morning, like Saad and I, our friend Saad, we were in the same room and someone released the cat and then closed the door in our room. And then we literally like got up, our eyes half closed, picked it up, put it back with Shamir, and we just hear, no!
Is the cat hallway. Like meowing or something? Like, why is it bothering you so much at night?
It's just a very attached cat. It just like, it doesn't mind its business.
It was super friendly. Don't get me wrong. Mm-hmm. If during the day, like, I would love to touch it, like play around with it. Yeah. It was so cute. But like at night, I'm trying to get my work done and it was like needing attention.
Okay,
very cute cat.
Does he look like he could do anything?
That John is evil. That John is evil.
Oh, it's so cute.
Yeah.
Can we get a, if we can see that.
Cat close up.
Probably can't see it.
Yeah.
But no, I want to talk about like the Cleveland experience is kind of funny because at that point in your life, like you ditched everything to move with a girl in Cleveland.
Ooh.
And then like that, you know, didn't go through.
Sure.
And you're in this, like one of what people think is like the worst cities in America.
Yeah, yeah.
By yourself. And the whole reason you moved there was because of
her. That's brave. Well, how'd you get to do that?
You don't know that I might have loved Cleveland, you know, and wanted to always live there. No, yeah. I mean, so the thing is like, you know, you say like, oh, it's like a worst city, like it's depressing, right? But in that situation is like where you make the best friends, right? Because you've got like 9 months of winter. You've got like, yeah, it's just brutal. Like, and you just bond with people. My job there was like really difficult.
Was everybody there depressed?
I wouldn't say depressed, but definitely
mellow
drinking.
Mm. So depressed.
Yeah, I think when we got there, actually, there was nobody anywhere, right? We were like, where is everyone? We were walking around like, it's the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame is there, right?
Yeah, did you guys go?
We didn't go inside, but we were outside.
We were chilling outside.
But no one was anywhere. And then we go by the bars and they're just packed.
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah.
And we're like, oh, this is.
Yeah. And I think it's like, you know, I don't want to stereotype the entire Midwest, but it's very much like, let's pack it in. Let's just, you know, have a good time, you know, get a little bit of alcohol on our system and root on our whatever sports teams we have. You know, in Cleveland, they had LeBron at the time.
And there's LeBron posters everywhere.
Yeah. They're riding LeBron. And, but you know, this is like the middle of America. This is the part of America that, you know, it's good to experience for better or for worse. And I really have nothing but nice things to say about the people that I met there. And I'm glad that I had the experience. But at the end of the day, it was like when it was time to leave, I was like, yeah, I'm out. Like I grew up on the East Coast. Like
so you made like what you could out of the experience.
Yeah, totally. Like it was cool. I'm trying to think what I did for fun. Like I would go bowling.
Well, you left for fun. You like, yeah. I think we had picked you up when you got back from some island.
Yeah, I was in the Bahamas.
You're in the Bahamas, yeah.
But like, I was gonna ask, like, you know, I don't want to get too deep into like the relationship stuff.
Sure,
but
sure,
like,
sure.
After that split, like, you know, was it, you know, being sadly kind of like alone there?
What an indie movie.
It was, yeah. So it was actually like, actually for the better, right? Because, well, it's hard to say because the breakup.
Did she live there? And then you just were like, let me join you over there?
She lived here because we went to school here. And then I did this whole thing in Morocco. She went back to Ohio. And then when I came back from Morocco, I was looking for work. And it was between Baltimore and Cleveland. It was over a few months, settled on Cleveland, got a job. Got out there, got my apartment set up, and it was almost as like, as soon as I finished signing the lease, it was like we pretty much broke up. Oh. Like you sign one of those year long leases. I don't know. Like she just wasn't about it. Like, and I knew it. You know, I could sense it. And
is that why you moved there? Because you're like trying to fix it?
No. I moved there. It was like there was like months of like, hey, should we do this? Like, and it was like, yes, let's do it. But then like actually me going there, like that actual commitment, probably a few things about my personality on top of that. Probably like, you know, just I don't know. Like,
I mean, it doesn't work out sometimes.
Didn't work out, but it happened right at the beginning. So it was like, okay, I got like 9 months to kill at least because I was a school teacher and it's like you can't leave the kids, especially in the kids that were in the situation like that I was teaching, like they need teachers to
Are you allowed to say
there.
What it was for or no?
Yeah, like I mean, it was with like Teach for America. Yeah, and it's like, you know, the biggest problem is like teachers that like leave in the middle of the year. It's already hard to find teachers. And so I was like, yeah, like I can't leave in the middle of the year. And it just wasn't practical. So it was really hard, but like that's the thing. Like it just forced me to make friends. And it's kind of similar to all my other travel experiences where I am just alone. It prepared me for just being like a solo traveler in general.